Everything got quiet. Good afternoon. And welcome everybody to the celebration of life for Leslie Robert Mills. It's just so warm and comforting to see you all here today. It really is. I know that the girls and Leslie Jr. are really pleased that you're here visiting and honoring Leslie. Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, how grateful we are that we have someone as loving and compassionate as you. One who we can turn to in our hour of need. You alone know our thoughts of every heart that is bowed in your presence and needs and the needs of each. And so I'd ask that you would comfort all who mourn as only you can. We thank you today for Leslie and the influence he had on his family and many friends throughout the years. We pray that his memory might be an inspiration to each of us, that no one of us knows the day or the hour when our time will come to leave this world. Grant that in our time here today, we all hear the word of God and with an open heart, that's pleasing to you. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to have a slideshow and a little bit of music to go along with it, hopefully.
My dreams to turn into something I could believe in, and looking for that magic rainbow on the horizon, I couldn't see it until I let go, gave in to love, watched all the bitterness burn. Now I'm coming alive, body and soul, feeling my world start to turn. And I'll taste every moment and live it out loud. I know this is the time. This is the time to be more than a name, more peace in the crowd. I know this is the time. Into the air, left me in pieces, but now I'm rising from the ashes, finding my wings, and all that I needed was there all along, within my reach, as close as the beat of my time.
grave to grieve. Wish I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high.
Leslie's journey's not over. It's just begun. Today we've come to celebrate and share the loss of Leslie. We've come to remember, tell stories, and say goodbye to him. And as hard as it is, this service will help us begin the process of grieving him. We will celebrate, remember, and honor Leslie on how he lived. He loved his children, his family, and friends. And let us be reminded that Leslie is in heaven. He's in heaven, where there's peace, joy, comfort, and happiness. I had the opportunity to talk to Leslie about this. It's been a long time. But he accepted Christ. I know in my heart. I wasn't there. But I know he did. Today I'm reminded of when Jesus was hung on the cross. In Luke chapter 23. And Jesus was hanging on the cross, and he had a couple of people with him, a couple of criminals. One mocked him for who he was, and the other one believed. He believed in the Messiah. The one that believed turned to him and said, "Will you remember me?" And Jesus turned to him and said to him, "Today you will be in paradise. You will be in heaven with me." And that's what he did for Leslie. The very same thing. And it's for all of us. All of us. Leslie believed in Jesus Christ. Jesus knew the heart of the man beside him, and he also knew Leslie's heart. In Ephesians 2:8-9 says, God saved you by his grace when you believed. He by his grace when you believed. And you can't take credit for this. It is a gift. It is a gift from God. Salvation is not a reward for good things that we've done. So none of us can boast about it. And Leslie had a tough life. But God took him into Whitecourt, where he overcame his problems that he had and helped people. He helped addicts, drug addicts. He helped alcoholics and people that just needed an ear. So folks, he did have a good life. Will you pray with me? Father God, we thank you for your son Jesus. We thank you for Leslie. We thank you for what your son did for him and what he did for a lot of other people. Lord, yes, we're going to miss him here. But it says, as I mentioned a minute ago, his journey's not over. It's just begun with you. So, Lord, I ask you to touch everybody's heart here today. And I ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. Can I have Chris come up, please?
Leslie Robert Mills III, May 5th, 1947. Les passed away February 19th, 2022, a day before Mother's birthday. Two months, 14 days before his 75th birthday. And he was also born a day after Father's birthday. And I try not to drag this out or anything, but Les was the first of six children in the Mills family. Big brother to Bill and Randy, myself, my baby sister Lorraine, and James, my baby brother. I'm not trying to make this sound like it's about me, but he was my big brother was your big brother and yours. And yours, Lorraine, Randy. He's my educator, teacher, protector, my longest best friend. He was always looking out for me, but he's always looking out for all of you also. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any of you. That's right. He saved my life. When I was 5 years, 6 years old, we all went to the West End pool, Bill, Randy, and me. And I was going down for the third time, and he grabbed my hand and pulled me out. And this is the result. If it wasn't for him, Les and I were really close all of our life. Always looking out for me, spoiling me a bit. You know, he was quite the character. Bill, you remember Sunnyside Creek? We all went out there, weekend and that. The guy was saving lives. Like a little child was floating down that river, maybe 2 years old. Lady screaming. He runs. He grabs a kid out of that river from drowning. There's lots that that man did for everybody. One time there, I was, I think I was about 4 years old in Lauderdale, climbing on a fence. The next door neighbor pushed me off. Down I went onto the sidewalk, gash in my head. He was cheesed. He caught the guy the next day. Yeah. He caught him and he said, well, you touch any of my brothers, again, the old saying goes, I'll knock your block off. And yeah, needless to say, we never seen the guy again, right? Like it's, but this is what I mean by a protector. He had Bill and he had Randy and myself at that time. Lorraine came, just a little bit after that. I need some more. Jeez. Yeah, he was a good friend to everyone. He did have a really tough life. I don't know how he got through it, but he did. He made me mad a few times, just like James did, just about getting killed in an accident, and Les getting gored by a bull. Yeah. This high, riding a 500-pound bull. In the hospital he went. So, yeah, I was a little angry at him about that. He did some things, too. Nobody's perfect. We're all flawed, every one of us. But he lived out his life, and he was, as my oldest son said, he was the most free-spirited man he ever met. He's a funny guy, kind of guy, you know. He'd done so many good things for people, you know, and never bragged about it or anything like that. Well, once in a while, hey, that was a pretty good thing I did last week. Never heard about it again, ever. That was less. Grew up, had a lot of good times with Jen. Tara, Leslie Jr. was just small. I don't know what to say anymore. It's just doing eulogies are a tough thing to do. I had to look it up to kind of see what it was about. Of course, it had to say, oh, yeah, the toughest ones are your sisters or your brothers, right? Like, boy, is that ever true. I love you, Les. We'll see you soon. We'll be catching fish again.
Okay. It's going to be a luncheon out that way and then down the hall somewhere. I don't know where it's at. Find it for yourself. No, it's out there. They're going to lead you. They'll lead you out there. But I'll just bless the meal, and then we'll go and have the fellowship. Father God in heaven, we come to you today, Lord. We thank you for this day. And again, we thank you for Leslie's life. Lord, bless this food that we're about to eat for our minds and our souls. And Lord, I also ask for safe travel for everybody when they do leave, that you'll put your hedge of protection around them and keep them safe. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Stormy sea.
up to more than I can.